another devastating blow to Canada's energy industry. On his first day in office as president, Joe Biden rescinded the executive order permitting the construction of the Keystone XL pipeline, a pipeline that was to bring Canadian oil to U.S. Gulf refineries and that's already been under construction for years. This marks a complete day one capitulation to American-funded activists determined above all to keep Canadian oil in the ground. Instead, the U.S. will now be forced to source oil from other countries like Venezuela, Iran, and Saudi Arabia, countries with little to no environmental protections and, let's be frank, no respect for human rights. It will also lead to immediate job losses for thousands of Canadian and American workers, most of them unionized at the worst possible time. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. Alberta taxpayers also invested over $1 billion in the project, which they will now likely lose. And the rail lines that will be used to ship some of this oil instead are less safe, less efficient, and actually produce more CO2 emissions than the pipeline would have. And what's even more frustrating is the blatant hypocrisy. Over the past 8 years, the Americans have built pipelines in their own country equal in length to more than 10 Keystone XLs. Unfortunately, the Liberal government here in Canada, all this being said, hasn't done much better, thwarting or canceling both the Energy East and Northern Gateway pipelines. So while Biden's Keystone XL decision is terrible for the economy and does nothing for the environment, it's hard to get too mad at the Americans for torpedoing our energy industry when our own government here at home has been doing the exact same thing.